What do you think is the largest organ in your body? Pause the video and write your best guess in your guided notes. As it turns out, the largest organ in your body is actually your skin. Skin isn't something you typically think of as an organ, but it is a group of tissues with a specific purpose. It's part of the integumentary system, which we'll be discussing today, along with three other body systems, as we describe the basic functions and structure of each of these systems, summarize best practices for keeping them healthy, and review body systems previously covered in this lesson. Let's get into it. The integumentary system is made up of the skin, hair, nails, and glands, which secrete substances such as oil. The skin protects us from injury and infection, while also helping to regulate our body temperature. Additionally, it works with the nervous system to help us sense our environment, such as feeling heat or cold. The skin has many layers and contains cells that produce melanin, which gives color to our skin, hair, and eyes. Hair and nails are made of a protein called keratin. Sweat and oil glands in the skin help keep the skin moisturized and prevent it from drying out. The integumentary system is constantly renewing itself, and it is important to take care of it by keeping it clean, protecting it from the sun, and staying hydrated. It is recommended that you drink at least 8 cups of water, or 64 ounces, per day, and your skin can benefit from hydrating oils or lotions as well. Next up is the immune system. This body system works together with your skin to defend against harmful invaders, such as bacteria or viruses. Specialized cells called white blood cells recognize and attack germs that don't belong in the body. These microscopic defenders are manufactured and stored in various organs in the body, which include the thymus, spleen, lymph nodes, and bone marrow, or insides of your bones. It's important to take care of your immune system by eating a healthy diet, getting quality sleep, exercising regularly, and managing stress. Also, according to scientists, vaccines such as the polio vaccine can help to strengthen the immune system by teaching it to recognize and fight off certain germs before we even get sick. Next up is the endocrine system, which is a group of glands that produce hormones. Hormones are chemical messengers that travel through the bloodstream to different parts of the body. These hormones help control many important functions in the body, such as growth, metabolism, and mood. The main glands in the endocrine system are the hypothalamus, pituitary gland, thyroid, pancreas, adrenal glands, and gonads. Each gland produces specific hormones that have a specific job in the body. For example, the thyroid gland produces hormones that help regulate the body's metabolism. The pancreas produces insulin, which helps control blood sugar levels. The endocrine system works closely with the nervous system to help the body respond to changes in the environment and maintain balance or homeostasis. Keeping your endocrine system healthy can be achieved by eating a healthy diet, exercising regularly, and managing stress. The final system we'll discuss is the excretory system, which is responsible for removing waste products from the body. Like all body systems, it works closely with other systems to accomplish its purpose. The main organs of the excretory system are the lungs, liver, kidneys, and skin. The lungs remove carbon dioxide, a waste product of respiration, through breathing. The liver detoxifies harmful substances, and the kidneys filter the blood to remove waste products and excess water, which are then eliminated as urine. The skin also plays a role in excretion, as it eliminates waste products through sweat. Some ways to maintain the health of the excretory system are staying hydrated, eating a healthy diet, and managing stress. Phew! That was a lot of body systems. Take a second to pat yourself on the back. Next, pause the video and complete the reflection in your guided notes of what we just covered. Welcome back! To wrap up this lesson, let's review the other body systems we've covered in this unit. The nervous system, which includes our brain and nerves, is the command center that relays electrical signals. The respiratory system, which includes our airways and lungs, exchanges oxygen and carbon dioxide with our environment. Meanwhile, our circulatory system, which includes our heart and blood vessels, transports materials throughout our body. Additionally, the musculoskeletal system, which includes our bones and muscles, protects our internal organs from harm, enables movement, and generates heat. Finally, the digestive system breaks down food into nutrients and absorbs them into the bloodstream. And with that, we've wrapped up our unit on body systems. Did you notice any overlap between the functions and how to keep them healthy? None of these systems work entirely by themselves. They all have their own important jobs, but they also rely on each other for support. Together, they all keep the entire body operating smoothly. In our next unit, we'll dive into the immersive field of ecology, where we'll be putting together everything we've learned so far in this course to examine how living things interact with each other. Until then, fellow biologists, I'm Anthony, and remember, life is full of wonders, so keep learning and don't ever stop wondering. Bye. Hey.